before I came on. Isn't that a great song? Anyway, I'm gonna get into that, but I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful day. Merry Christmas if you listen to this after the 25th. I hope your Christmas was great. I hope you was able to spend time with family and just enjoy one another. I think that's one of the things that that we've all have learned or should have learned from this year, that family and being together with people you love, it gives you a whole new appreciation for life, right? So hopefully your Christmas was great, and hopefully the rest of your holiday is going to be awesome. But listen, if you listen to that song when you came in, okay, that was by Hezekiah Walker and the Love Fellowship Choir. It's a CD live in New York, and it was called By Any Means. That CD came out in 1995. Honestly, that is like one. Hezekiah Walker has produced some awesome, praiseworthy music over the years, but that CD, it just is one of my favorites. And when we were singing in the choir, you know, I grew up in a Pentecostal church, and so, you know, we had what we call a the council. It was every summer where, you know, the choirs, the whole churches came together, and we formed this big choir, and we sung, you know, those songs. And that was one of, I think that was one of the songs that we sung, and it was another song off of a CD of his that we sung. Was a song, a CD that he did in London. Hopefully I have a picture of that, but yeah, check those out. But listen, I was in my prayer time on this morning, and I just began to talk to the Lord and just began to tell him, God, listen, any way you bless me, I will be satisfied. Any way you bless me, I will be satisfied. And I think sometimes we have to get that in our spirit. Lord, any way you bless me, it doesn't matter if it's tangible or intangible, you know, I will be satisfied. You know, tangible things are those things that we can touch, we can feel, we can see, you know, and whatever. And those intangible things are a little hard, because those are the things we can't see. Those are the things we can't touch, you know, and in some cases, those are the things we can't even hear, you know, or whatever. But I just began to tell God, thank you. But the words of that song is, any way you bless me, I'll be satisfied. You can wipe the tears from my eyes and put joy inside. So even if it's, Lord, you wiping the tears from my eyes and giving me some joy, you know, I'll be satisfied with that. You know, I think and when I sat on the bed, it was like the Lord spoke to me and was like, you know, we live in a society where people want tangible things. If it's nothing that, if it's not something that they can see or taste or feel or put their hands on, then, you know, then they ignore it, you know. But breathing, even though it's intangible, but that's a blessing, right? So, you know, I would just begin to thank God. I was like, yes, God. You know, I remember my friend Tay, you know, I'm gonna link her channel down in the description box. You guys, please go and listen to Tay. She has a YouTube channel called Inspire Me, and it's really a good channel. She talk about relatable events that relates to the word of God, and just how God, you know, uses her and brings things to her mind on a daily basis. And she's even got to the point to where she started doing like little skits and stuff before her scenes, and which is awesome. being a, as they say, a drama major, I love skits. I love acting of any kind. So listen, go check her channel out. It's great. But Tay began to talk about last week, I'm not for sure what video it was, about testimonies and whatever. And it took my mind back to a newsletter that God blessed me to do. And I talked about testimonies in the newsletter. And, you know, I just began to say how, you know, when we used to have testimony service growing up, you know, and some people, now I understand why they took testimony service out of church, because some people just went a little overboard. But I loved testimony service because, you know, it would just gave you hope. You know, when people would get up and they would talk about the goodness of God and what God did for them. And, you know, and if you're praying for God for a home or a car or a child or a job, you know, and somebody get up and they say how God has blessed them with a home, a car, a child, job, or whatever, or even money in the bank, that was an encouragement to you, because it was like, okay, God, if you did it for them, then I know you can do it for me. But my problem, even though I love testimony service, but I wouldn't get up and really do it too much, because I felt like if I didn't have anything or experience anything tangible, in other words, if God didn't bless me with a job, if he didn't bless me with a car, if he didn't bless me with a home, if he didn't bless me to the things that I felt like, you know, was testimony worthy, then I just sat in my seat. I listened to everybody else give their testimony, but I felt like I didn't have anything to give God praise for. And what I was missing was, honey, if you're breathing, just the fact of being able to sit there, you know, in the midst of saints or other believers was a blessing all by itself. Just the fact of being able to breathe is a blessing all by itself. You know, just to, you know, you may not have everything you want in the refrigerator, but just to be able to go and get into your cabinets and, hey, I may got beans, but that's a blessing. I didn't feel like praising God for those small things, those intangible things, was praiseworthy. You know, so I would sit in my seat and I wouldn't get up and say anything. But then one day I was sitting in church and I was like, you know what? Just to be able to leave home, to touch my doorknob when I leave the house, and to be able to touch that same doorknob when I come back home, that's a miracle. Do you know how many people that touch their doorknob in the morning and they go out and they don't ever come back? They don't come back to touch that same doorknob. You know, something as simple and as small as that, we tend to overlook. But God wants us to give him praises for the smallest things, or as I would like to call them, the little ant things, as opposed to the big, big things. It's easy to give God praise over the big, big things, you know, because that's something we can see. You know, that's something praiseworthy, right? But those little ant things, that's praiseworthy too. You know, just to be able to be in your right mind, have life, health, and strength, a roof over your head. You know, I love the fact what the song says. If you can wipe the tears from my eyes and put joy inside. Joy is intangible, but that's a blessing. It's a blessing to have joy. You know, and I know right now, you know, like I said in other videos, we're going through a pandemic. You know, but just to be able to be happy in this season, to have joy in a season like this that we're experiencing, to be able to have even the smallest things. You know, when people are out and they running rampant, trying to get tissue, trying to get sanitizer, trying to, you know, wiping the shelves clean of stuff, you know. But even if God, they wipe the shelves clean of stuff, God still bless you. And I am a living witness for this. God still bless you to find tissue. He still bless you to find the paper towels, you know, and whatever. I have gone to stores and things have, shelves have been wiped clean of things. But God, he came around and made a way, you know, for me to get tissue out of the blue. Paper towels out of the blue. And I'm like, God, thank you. You know, I don't have a lot, but I thank you for what I do have, you know. And I was just like, God, no matter what, no matter how you bless me, I am going to be satisfied and I won't complain. The power of your spirit, it will ease the pain, the song says. And then it goes on to say, anyway, I'll be satisfied. Any way you bless me, God, I'll be satisfied. And that is something that we need to say today. Tangible or intangible, whether it's something I can feel or something I can't even see, God, I will be satisfied any way you bless me. I pray that this message was an encouragement to you. Hey, if you liked it, hey, leave a like, leave a comment. Let me know what you thought and let me know what you are thankful for. Let me know some intangible things that you are thankful, that you thank God for in the comments, okay? I hope you have a great day. Hey, I'll talk to you soon.